Hello friends, welcome to the Safety Hunts channel. Today in this video, I am going to discuss about lifting plan. Lifting operations are among the major causes of fatalities and serious incidents in global exploration and production activities. Despite the vast number of regulations, standards and guidelines that apply to lifting, incidents continue to occur. One of the important documents necessary during the lift is lifting plan. A lifting plan is required for every lift. If the lift deviates from the plan, make it safe and stop the job. A lifting plan provides a systematic approach towards planning a lift and ensure that the lifting operation is properly managed. For example, a lifting plan would ensure that the crane is safely deployed and operated, and the lifting crew are clear about their roles and responsibilities. Now we will see about the necessary things we need before starting a lifting plan. We need to know about the type of crane and capacity of the crane. And also we need to know about the lifting tools and tackles going to be used during the lifting, like chain block, D-shackles, web slings, or it could be spreader beam, whatever it is. And types of hook, like single fall hook, four fall, six fall, whatever the types of hook we are going to use, that should be here. And the load chart is extremely important. Weight of the load, I mean, what load we are going to use, and the sling angle, web slings angle, because it affects the load, and the counterweight if it is applicable. Next, we will see about the calculations, the main calculations of the lifting plan. You can see here two things. Boom length and working radius, which is very important and we should know it. How we get it from site? We have to do the site visit before making this calculation. At site, you will clearly know how much boom length we need and how much radius we are going to use for this lift. Once we get the boom length and this corresponding radius, we can easily calculate the rated capacity of the crane. From where we get it, it's where the lifting plan comes, I'm sorry, the load chart comes in. From this load chart, you can see this vertical section has given all the working radiuses, and this horizontal section has given the boom length. So as per our calculation, 32 meters is our boom length and 14 meter is our working radius. So if you match here, we will get around 3.810, which is 3,800 kgs. So in this calculation we have mentioned it here, so you can see now we will get this value from the load chart. From the load chart you have to take it. So now this you have to calculate weight of the equipment, which you already know from the manufacturer, or you can calculate by yourself using some formulas. So this is the weight of the hook. It's again depend upon the type of crane and the type of equipment we are going to lift. For example, we will have this one fall hook, which is of around 3 to 5 kgs. I am considering here four fall hook, which is 250 kg quarter ton, and weight of the sling and shackles, which includes the weight of spreader beams, chain blocks and web sling, and many more. D shackle, B shackle, everything comes in. Total weight will be the summation of weight of the slings, weight of the hook, and the weight of the equipment. If we add these three things, you will get it around here, 2,350 kgs. So now we will calculate the percentage of the capacity used. I mean, how much percentage of the crane are going to be used, the capacity of the crane. So how we are going to calculate it, it will be the total lift weight divided by the crane rated capacity into 100. The total lift weight we already got here by adding these three elements, and divided by the rated crane capacity already we have here from the load chart into 100. 100 is here to convert it in percentage. So we are getting around 61.84%, which means only 61.84% of the crane's capacity we are going to use. So to calculate the safety factor, it should be subtracted from 100. So 100 minus 61.84, we are having 38.15% of the safety factor, which is quite good. Okay, so this is how we are going to, we have to calculate a lifting plan. This is a basic lifting plan. It can be applied anywhere. And now I'm going to show you how to calculate a boom angle of the crane as well as the height. Okay, because the boom length and the radius we will get from site itself. So as per our calculation, this is the boom length of the crane, which is 32 meters, and 14 meters is the working radius. So we know that cos theta is equal to base by hypotenuse from the trigonometry. It's a basic formula. So theta is equal to cos inverse base by hypotenuse. Base is nothing but this working radius, which is 14. And the hypotenuse is the boom length, which is 32. And if you do the math here, you will get 64 degrees here, which means the crane boom will be of 64 degrees while doing this lift. How to calculate the height now? Here the Pythagoras theorem will take, will be applied here. So we know that the, according to the Pythagoras theorem, the perpendicular, I mean the hypotenuse square is equal to this base square plus the perpendicular square. The perpendicular is nothing but here the height, and the base is nothing but the radius, and the hypotenuse is the boom length. So height is equal to root inverse of boom length square minus the radius square. So we have the boom length 32 square minus the 14 square. So we have square root of 828. And if we do the math, we'll get around 28.77 meters, which is the height of this boom, tip of the boom to the ground level. Okay. So this is a typical load chart, which I have shown you already. This is for a 25-ton cranes. And there are many load charts applicable and available for many cranes. And it also depends upon the counterweight. Here it is zero counterweight. So if there is a counterweight of 10 ton or 5 ton or 50 ton, so the load chart will vary depend on it. Now we will see about the relationship between the sling angle versus the load. Consider this as a web sling or a web belt we used to say commonly. So if it is a 110 belt, so if the load is 110, we can use it directly if it's a vertical lift, 90 degrees directly. If the angle of the sling, I mean the belt, get lower, so the load also get, the capacity of this belt will also get low. For example, if the same 110 belt is inclined in 60 degrees, only 865 kgs could be lifted. Here 100%, all the 110, 1000 kg will be lifted, here only 865 kgs. If we further reduce the sling angle only to 45, only 70%, which means 700 kgs will be lifted for 110 belt, and it will go down. So in short, we can say, so lower the sling angle, the capacity of the lift, I mean, will get lower. So this is a sample lifting plan for you guys. So this lifting plan, you can use it anywhere. This is a sample one. Here you can see on the top the description of the load, which might be equipment, what we are going to lift exactly. Concrete block, pipes, vessel, or some kind of wooden logs or generators, whatever the equipment you are going to lift, you should mention here. And the project name, under what project you are going to lift it, the location where it is exactly going to lift, for example, any tank cages or trains or CDUs, wherever it is, you can mention here. And this is the section where the guy who is going to prepare it, his name should come here, and here who's going to approve it, his name or her name should be here. So this is the crane details, actually, the crane manufacturers, the model numbers, the registration, third party inspection, due date, and the maximum rated lift of the crane. I mean, the total capacity of the crane, like 25 ton, 50 ton, 300,000, whatever the capacity. This third party inspection is extremely important for the crane. If it is a material lift crane, yearly once could be done. And if it is a man lift, which means in some cases the cranes are going to be used to lift a man using a man basket, that kind of cranes, third party inspection should be done in every 6 months. So this should be followed at a close circle. So this is the important part of a lifting plan, which is lifting details. This I have already explained to you. And these four people should sign on the lifting plan. Why? Because these two people, the preparer and the approver, they will prepare it, and sometimes they won't communicate these to the site people. But these four people, the supervisor, HSE officer, the rigger, and the crane operator, will be the guys actually executing the work at site. So these four people actually knows what's going on in the lifting plan. So which is why their signature is most important. So once they have signed, this lifting plan is valid, and we can execute it. So that's all in this video, my friends. If you have any comments on what I have just explained you so far, kindly comment me down. I'll be happy to explain you back. Kindly subscribe my channel to get more videos whenever I upload. Thank you.